Our Old Testament lesson comes to us from the 31st chapter of Jeremiah, reading verses 7 through 14. For thus says the Lord, sing aloud with gladness for Jacob, and raise shouts for the chief of the nations. Proclaim, give praise, and say, save, O Lord, your people, the remnant of Israel. See, I am going to bring them from the land of the north, and gather them from the farthest parts of the earth, among them the blind and the lame, those with child and those in labor together. A great company they shall return here. With weeping they shall come, and with consolations I will lead them back. I will let them walk by brooks of water, in a straight path in which they shall not stumble. For I have become a father to Israel, and Ephraim is my firstborn. Hear the words of the Lord, O nations, and declare it in the coastlands far away. Say, he who scattered Israel will gather him, and will keep him as a shepherd a flock. For the Lord has ransomed Jacob, and has redeemed him from hands too strong for him. They shall come and sing aloud on the height of Zion, and they shall be radiant over the goodness of the Lord, over the grain, the wine, and the oil, and over the young of the flock and the herd. Their life shall become like a watered garden, and they shall never languish again. Then shall the young women rejoice in the dance, and the young men shall be merry. I will turn their mourning into joy. I will comfort them and give them gladness for sorrow. I will give the priests their fill of fatness, and my people shall be satisfied with my bounty, says the Lord. Hear also the epistle lesson for this Lord's Day. As we turn to Paul's letter to the Ephesians, the first chapter, reading verses 3 through 14. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places, just as he chose us in Christ before the foundation of the world to be holy and blameless before him in love. He destined us for adoption as his children through Jesus Christ, according to the good pleasure of his will, to the praise of his glorious grace that he freely bestowed on us in the beloved. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses, according to the riches of his grace that he has lavished upon us. With all wisdom and insight, he has made known to us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure that he set forth in Christ, as a plan for the fullness of time to gather up all things in him, things in heaven and things on earth. In Christ, we have also obtained an inheritance, having been destined according to the purpose of him who accomplishes all things according to his counsel and will, so that we who were the first to set our hope on Christ might live for the praise of his glory. In him, you also, when you heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and had believed in him, were marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit. This is the pledge of our inheritance toward redemption as God's own people, to the praise of his glory. Listen also for the gospel lesson from the first chapter of John, reading verses 10 through 18. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. John testified to him and cried out, this was he of whom I said, he who comes after me ranks ahead of me because he was before me. From his fullness we have all received grace upon grace. The law indeed was given through Moses, and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. It is God, the only Son, who is close to the Father's heart, who has made him known. Here ends the scripture for this Lord's Day. May the Lord add the Lord's blessing in the reading and the proclamation of God's holy word. Children, lead us.
A long time ago, in the town of Nazareth, lived a young woman named Mary. Mary did her chores, was kind to others, and loved God very much. She was engaged to be married to Joseph, who was a carpenter. One day, while Mary was at home cleaning her room, an angel suddenly appeared. Before Mary could even say anything, the angel said, "You are favored by God. God is with you." Mary was surprised. She was trying not to be afraid, but she had never seen an angel before. After all, Mary was just a regular lady like you or I. Why was this angel visiting her? What did the angel want? The angel quickly tried to reassure Mary, saying, "Do not be afraid. God has found favor with you. You will have a baby boy and are to give him the name Jesus." Mary was confused. She was not yet married to Joseph, so how could she have a baby? The angel thought this might concern Mary, so she said, "The Holy Spirit will perform a miracle. And because of this, your baby will be called the Son of God." To Mary's surprise, the angel had more exciting news. "Even your cousin Elizabeth is going to have a son in her old age." Many thought that she couldn't have children, but she is already pregnant. Nothing is impossible with God. Mary couldn't believe what she was hearing. She didn't know what to say. She realized that she was trembling and knelt down. When she was finally able to speak, she said, "I am the Lord's servant, and I hope everything you have said will come true." The angel then disappeared, and Mary was left alone. Soon after, Joseph and Mary were talking, and Mary told him of the good news, that she was going to have a baby. Joseph was confused and upset by this. That night, when he went to sleep, an angel came to him in a dream. The angel said to Joseph, "Joseph, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife. The child Mary is going to have is God's son, and you are to give him the name Jesus." When Joseph woke up the next morning, he remembered what the angel had said and knew that everything was okay, and he wasn't upset anymore. In those days, the government decided that they should count everyone that lived in that area of the world. So Joseph had to take Mary to his town, Bethlehem, to register. It took Mary and Joseph a long, long time to get to Bethlehem. They didn't have cars back then, so it probably took them a lot longer to get there than we would think. This was very tiring for Mary because she was soon going to have a baby. When they reached the town, all the hotels were full and there was nowhere that they could stay. The Bible doesn't say for sure where they stayed, but most people think that they stayed in a small barn where animals were kept. Lots of animals. In any case, doesn't it seem strange that Jesus, the King of the Jews, wasn't born in a fancy palace or even a hospital? Mary and Joseph were thankful that they had at least a place to lie down. It was warm and there was plenty of straw to lie on. That night, an exciting, wonderful thing happened. Mary and Joseph had a baby. They always shoot out like that. It wasn't just any baby, it was baby Jesus. The creator of the whole world, the King of Kings, the one who would save the world. The little baby boy fell asleep in Mary's arms, and she wrapped him in cloths. Gently wrapped him in cloths. And laid him in a manger. Mary and Joseph soon fell asleep. They were so glad to have this special baby join their family. Later that night, some shepherds who lived near Bethlehem were out in their fields watching over their sheep. They were worried a bigger animal might come and hurt the sheep, so they sat on a hill visiting and watching their sheep together. Suddenly, there was a bright light. Now, this wasn't just any bright light. The light was so bright that they had to close their eyes for a minute because the light hurt their eyes. When they opened their eyes to see what was going on, a beautiful angel was standing in the air just above them with her arms open wide. The shepherds looked at each other in disbelief, but realized it must be real because they were all seeing the same thing. All at once, they were very afraid, but they didn't run because they were too stunned to do anything. Then the angel spoke to them. Do not be afraid. I am here to bring you good news for all people. Today in Bethlehem, a baby has been born. He is the one that will save the world. You will know the baby because he will be wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger. Suddenly, just as quickly as the first angel came, there were a large group of angels, and they said together, "Glory to God, and peace to all people on earth." After they spoke, they floated away. The shepherds were amazed and excited. Did everyone know this news, or just them? They had to go see this baby the angels were talking about. They ran as fast as they could to Bethlehem. They were filled with joy that they had found the Lord. The shepherds only stayed for a few minutes. They realized that Mary needed to sleep. As soon as they left, they began shouting in the streets and telling everyone they met about what they had seen.
Baby Jesus! Baby Jesus! Baby Jesus! Baby Jesus! Baby Jesus! Baby Jesus!
Mary sat and watched Jesus sleep. She was so happy. important person he was. Shortly after Jesus was born, the wise men were traveling on their camels. One night, they noticed a very strange star in the sky. They knew that this star meant the King of the Jews, the one who would save the world, had been born. During this time when Jesus was born, there was a very mean king who ruled the land. His name was King Herod, and when the mean King Herod heard this, he got very worried. He had called the wise men to a secret meeting. And he found out from them exactly what they saw about the star and what it meant. The wise men told King Herod that the scriptures told them that a king would be born and take care of all the people. He then told them to go and find this child and to tell him so that where he was, so that he could go worship him. After the wise men had spoken to the king, the wise men left to find the baby. They didn't know exactly where the baby was, but at night they followed the star in the east. They followed the star until it hung right over the place where Jesus was. When they finally had arrived, they were excited and happy. They found Jesus lying in Mary's arms, and they bowed down and worshiped him. After that, they gave the gifts they had brought Jesus. They were gold, frankincense, and myrrh. These were very expensive gifts, gifts that you could give to a king, not to a baby. Mary thanked them for bringing the gifts for Jesus, and the wise men went to find a place to sleep for the night. As the wise men were sleeping, they each had the same dream. They were not to go back and tell King Herod where they found Jesus. King Herod didn't want to find Jesus to worship him. He wanted to kill him because he was jealous that this baby would someday be better than him. So the next morning, the wise men woke up and went home another way so that King Herod would not know where they had come from. They also decided that they would not tell King Herod anything about what they had seen. This story of Christmas is special, full of miracles and strange visitors, all coming to visit a king and the savior of the world.